Hey guys, so I finally finished my mold. Actually, I had a couple of them made prior to this, and now I finally have a successful 22 mold that will not only work in Huben K1 but also in other air guns. Now you might ask yourself, why would you go and make a mold for 22? There's a lot of bullets and pellets out there. Well, mainly a couple of reasons. First of all, there are pellets and there are bullets. Bullets are usually for rimfire or something like that, and or cap and ball or something like that, and pellets are for air guns. But this high power air guns such as Huben, they don't fit in any of these categories. They are still air guns, but they are way more powerful than most of other, let's say, regular power air guns for the caliber. So if you look here, I have the, let's say, heaviest pellets that I selected to test in Huben K1, and actually all except this JSB Beast didn't perform well, and I will explain to you immediately why. I sorted this from lightest to heaviest. So basically we got the JSB Monster, H&N Rabbit Magnum Power and Rabbit Magnum 2, and then we have Eugene, and then I think it's called Skinko New Boy or something like that, and then we have the Destroyer, and then we have Pile Driver, which I had the highest hope for, and then we have a JSB Beast. All of these pellets have two problems. Some of them are shaped in a form of a pellet, which means that they have a skirt and they have a big drag, and therefore don't have a good ballistic coefficient. They do tend to shoot rather well, but for long range they are not that good because of this small ballistic coefficient. The bullet shape are better in terms of ballistic coefficient, but they have a general problem that all the manufacturers make them too small. Usually they are like about 5.52 millimeters or 5.56 or something like that, which is way too small to be accurate from any airgun or rimfire barrel, because airgun and rimfire barrel has grooves about 5.62, which is, so the bullet should, or the pellet should be bigger than that. That's not smaller. Of course, the head of the pellet can be smaller, but the skirt is always bigger, and always is bigger than the groove of any barrel for the airgun to be accurate. So basically that is why none of these are successful according to my criteria, because I'm looking for long range, so I'm looking for a good ballistic coefficient and low drag, and I'm looking for something that is accurate, and of course a powerful gun is needed to produce to get them flying fast enough. But still, Huben can do that, and that is why I went and developed my own mold. Now, before I started the development, I tested a mold from Lee, so Lee Molds, and they have a 2-5 option. This is a 55 grain bullet from 2-5 from Lee, which my original plan from the beginning was to shorten the mold down to have a shorter bullet to fit in Huben, because this is way too long for Huben. Huben has a limitation of 11 millimeters in length, and went and shortened it down and got this. Now, this already produced, let's say, reasonably good results, but from this batch by far the most accurate was still the JSB Beast. Okay, so after that I ran across to now my colleague Miha, which has an MP mold web store. So this is he designs and manufactures molds, So far he didn't do anything regarding air guns. That is where I came in, and together we developed a couple of different modes, and let's say we have a winner here. So basically we started with a bow tail. We wanted something with a good ballistic coefficient, and this was one of the first one. Sorry about that. I will show you the close-up images later, but this is a bow tail. It has a slightly flat tip and a bow tail, and there are two different versions. One of them is a bit shorter than the other and has a slightly smaller bow tail. Unfortunately, no matter what I did, I couldn't get really good results with any of the bow tail version that I designed. That's where I let go of this design and went for the more standard version, which was the by far the most accurate version of the bullet. And I ended up with three different versions. So basically we have this one, which has almost round nose, and you have one which has a slightly more curved nose, and then the most pointy one is this one, and this one is by far the most accurate of them all. In terms of weight, this one is about 36 to 37 grains, this one is about 39, and this one is about 41. Of course, depends on the alloy that you use, but they're pretty close and they are very consistent, and these that you're looking at are actually directly from the mold. You can see the background, how fast the molding process actually goes. In my experience, from what I tested, the best results in terms of accuracy came out of mixture when you mix 10 units of pure lead and 1 unit of linotype. So this was my choice, and also of course when you cast you have to pay attention to your alloy also because of the size of the bullet that you get out of your mold. Now I do still size those because this first prototype mold is slightly too big to fit in the Huben or any other gun for that matter. The dimensions of this bullets are, I don't know if you can see this, is about 5.7. I'm just turning now the bullet so you can see 5.7 or just a little over. So in inches this is about 2 to 4, yeah, 2 to 4. I think that 2 to 4 is 5.69 or something like that. So this is just a slightly too big to fit the Huben. Huben has a 2 to 3 or 5.66 dimension of the hole in its magazine. That's why I made this sizing die. This is a prototype, and this pin that pushes through, so pusher. I sized them. Two. So these are sized and these are still unsized. Let's measure one. So I'm in inches. So I got 2 to 3 exactly. 2 to 3. I'm turning it. If we go to millimeters, it's 5.66 all the way around. So these are now a perfect fit for Huben K1's magazine. They fit rather snug, so you have to use some force to push it in, but you can push them in all the way because they stop at the front, pellet guard, so the pellets don't fall out of the magazine. So you can push them all the way in, and they are just the right dimension not to block the rotation of the cylinder when the Huben 1 is in operation. So I'm just going to demonstrate how they fit in. I'm going to get a little closer.
So you just put them in like this, then you push them all the way, and they are perfectly flush in. Hope you can see that. Let's put another one in. So this front guard prevents the bullet from going too far in.
Okay, so as I mentioned, there are two shapes. This one is by far the most accurate. And I'll just bring the scale over here also, so we can measure the weight. So I'll just weigh the unsized first. So let's do it in grains. 36.62. And so these are the lightest one, the most accurate one. The medium ones are 39.06. 39.04, and let's test the heaviest one. So 40.82 and 40.94. Obviously I would have to measure a lot more of them in order to get a clear image on how the grainage varies between pellets, but as you can see, they are quite consistent in terms of weight. Now MP Molds is going to be offering this mold. So this is the mold, this is the actual mold that I was using. This is a prototype one, because this one has all three dimensions in one mold. The mold that MP Molds is going to be selling will be one dimension only. For starters, it will only be the lightest one, so the 36.5 grain version. And he will be selling in two different dimensions. One would be, it will be 0.223, and one will be in 0.224. Now the one in 0.224 will come with a sizing kit. So of course this is a prototype, but you will get professionally made. I made this myself just so I can size them for my own use. But it will be a sizing die that will size them down to 223. So basically, if you go back to millimeters, the mold that will need sizing, that the bullets will need sizing afterwards, will come about 5.69, and the one that will not require any sizing will be in 5.66 millimeters. Now, of course, you can, despite the fact that these molds are really, really excellent, I mean, you can see the thickness and the quality of the build. This one was used quite heavily, and it's still like new. You will still will get a slightly lower accuracy with unsized bullets than with sized. So that's of course, but there's a little additional work. But if you're watching this video in the background, you can see how fast this actually goes. So it's really not that big of a deal. So, in terms of the number of cavities, this one has 6 cavities. We were discussing with Miha that he would actually make 8 cavities, Now, if there were 8 cavities, it will probably come in form like this. So basically, this is without handles. And this one is has a double locking system, and it's easier to cut the excessive lead when molding, because you have this lever here to do that. This one you have to either use gloves and have, use a little more force, or just hit it with wood or plastic or something like that, a hammer or something like that. I can tell you that I use this one, which doesn't have a double locking, and it's still this, there's no gap, and it's a very, very, very high quality mold. MP Molds ships everything for free, so basically there's no shipping charges. You will see the prices on the webpage, and if you have if you're gonna use these bullets only for plinking, so not some really accuracy shooting, then I would go for the 223 mold, which doesn't require any sizing. Otherwise, if you're aiming for maximum accuracy, then I would definitely go with the version with the sizing kit with it. Now remember, you can use this same sizing kit also for other bullets that are available out there. So, because if you want to use any, let's say, bullets that are made for, as I mentioned before, for a rimfire or a cap and ball, they will require sizing in order to fit into Huben K1. So, that's it. I will put the link to MP Molds over here and the description below. So you can go to the direct link to MP Molds and purchase this mold. Next coming up is the accuracy I'm getting at 70 meters. Maybe just before we go to that shooting portion of the video, let me just mention a couple of things regarding in what barrels these bullets will perform well. Huben K1, actually I was just at Iowa in Nuremberg 2 weeks ago, yeah. And I met with Huben, so I will actually have a lot more videos on Huben. They will be sending me their new version of Huben K1, version 2. I believe it's already available in the US, maybe even also in Europe. So they made some changes, and two significant changes they made is they changed the barrel. So now the barrel has a slightly faster twist rate. So it's almost as fast twist as we offer with Royale if you buy a separate barrel. Now for these bullets, the faster the twist rate, the better it will be, of course. So if you have the new version, this will already shoot very accurate and stable. If you have the first version, custom barrel is recommended in order to get best performance. Also, the first barrel, the first stock barrel, is also choked, so it will also reduce the velocity of the bullet somewhat. So that's it. We are working with Royale on even faster twist rate that will stabilize also these even heavier bullets. Although I must say that you will, I think, find that these are really, really the best option, because you can still have a relatively low pressure. I'm shooting these with realistic pressure, 150 bars, or the regulated pressure of Huben. The gauge is actually showing 180, but the gauge is wrong. So just so you know, you might have the same situation on your K1. And they're shooting at about or just under 300 meters per second, so just under 1,000 feet per second. So this is a good speed, a good velocity. And, the basically very important thing about this is that they have a very good ballistic coefficient. There will also be a portion of the video on the end that will show you I'm actually measured the BC, not calculated, measured at 70 meters, and I got a BC of 0.14, Now, if you look at any of these, okay, let's leave this one out because they are not a standard pellet. If you measure any of these, the best is probably either pile driver because of his bottle design, or JSB Beast simply because of the weight. And they are also all have under, actually way under 0.1 BC, and this have 0.14. So at 70 meters at with initial velocity of 298 meters per second, I actually got over 270 meters per second at 70 meters. So that's the factor that lets you know that this bullet is meant for long range. In the future, there will probably also be a version with the hollow point, so basically for you hunters out there. I started with the standard design, and we'll see how successful that is. If it's very successful, then of course we will go with the development forward and give you more options, and also maybe even heavier types and lighter types, and whatever comes into play. But it all depends on you and how much you order and how much interest is there for this kind of product. As I mentioned before, these are not limited only for Huben. They would work in any high power air gun. There are some custom high power air guns out there, or some that develop reasonably high energies. Try them out. Before you try them out, just make sure that dimension this big will actually fit into the chamber of your air gun, because that can be a problem if the air gun is actually made for conventional pellets. Some of them do have this size, some of them don't. The good thing about this design is that it has only about, let me measure, about 5 millimeters of this surface that actually touches the barrel, the rifling. That also means that in terms of loading it to the chamber does not to be very deep inside. So basically, if you have a pellet chamber, it will be rimmed very shallowly, because pellet shallow, not shallowly, because pellet only has a last portion of it is actually thicker than the rifling, and the front portion is way slimmer. So they only enlarge the backside of the chamber, and that is also a good thing for these bullets, because they still are, it's probable that they will still load perfectly okay in air guns that are designed for pellets. But again, you have to try it out first, or measure or something like this, in order to know. I cannot guarantee that. So I sure hope I covered everything. If not, please leave a comment below, subscribe, and please let me know if you like this kind of products I'm developing. That will certainly bring focus to me to develop more. Also, let me know if you are interested in other calibers for air guns, some special designs. I know that there are already manufacturers out there that actually makes molds for air guns. There are mostly boat tail design. Personally, I haven't seen a boat tail that flies really accurate from an air gun. I believe that there are some, but according to my experience, I haven't found it yet. So again, please leave a comment, subscribe, and like the video if you like what I do. Thank you very much, and continue watching the accuracy and BC measurement. Thank you. Bye, guys.
Huben K1 on the custom barrel. 36.5 grain bullets. 70 meters. I have a crony, I'm going to let you know the velocities.
300 exactly meters per second, that is 301. I'm not sure, maybe I have another shot. I have six in the chamber, but I'm not sure. Yeah, there's another one. 301.1, just so you can see the corona as well. I'll show you. So that's 70 meters. And that's the corona. So last shot, 301.1. And currently I'm on the bottle, and that's only because I don't have a lot of air in the bottle anymore. And if I wasn't, then I would have to refill every, I don't know, 10 shots. So these are the bullets. I actually haven't tested all of them yet. The ones I was shooting now are the lightest from the options. So basically I have three sizes. This is the lightest, and I have casted a couple of different version in terms of hardness. So basically I had different additives to lead. I have some pure lead, which didn't turn out that well because they are just too soft, and then I'm adding linotype to make them harder. And these were from this batch. No, sorry, they were from this batch. So this is 6-to-1 ratio lead. So 6 units of lead and 1 unit of linotype. The lightest one seemed to be the most aerodynamic and also the most accurate. And they are shooting with the custom barrel, which I'm going to show also later to you. At 300, over 300 meters per second, so almost 1000 feet per second, with the regulator set to, it says here, I'm not sure if you can see that, it says here about 180 bars, but I tested this gauge, and it actually it's showing a lot more than it actually is. So this is actually 150 bars. So it's about 30 bars. It's showing 30 bars more than it the pressure actually is. So this grouping is really not bad. So these bullets are actually very accurate. These are sized to 0.223. This makes them perfect fit to the chamber of the, so the magazine of the Huben K1. You can use them also without sizing. I haven't tried it yet. I assume that the accuracy will be slightly lower because they're of course not as accurate as size, sized in terms of dimensions. So I'll do some more shooting, and you'll see what the results are. So we're shooting Huben K1 at 70 meters. I've got some special targets over there. What you see is if you go from the right to left, so let's try to get them in the middle of the frame. So what you see there from right to left is a 16 centimeter circle, then 8 centimeters, 4, and the last one it's 2 centimeters. So the smallest one is about 0.8 inches, I think, if you go in inches, and then each next one is twice as big as the previous one. So we'll start with let's say the 8 centimeters. I haven't really sighted the gun in properly yet, but still I should hit it. Nope. I think it's a little right and high. Let's try. Yeah. Okay. Let's try the second one, so the 4 centimeters. Yeah, it's a little to the right. Let's do one more. So the velocities are, this last shot was 302 meters per second. So that's just over 1,000 feet per second. Let's try the smallest one. Perfect. That's great to see. So 2 centimeters circle at 70 meters. That's 76 yards. 1:8 ratio. Bullets 36.7 grain, I believe. Distance is always 70 meters. And let's try it for accuracy. Velocity is, the second shot is 301.7 meters per second. Yeah, that was the last one. So that's probably the average group I get. The lightest bullets with 1-10 alloy. And let's give it a go. I'm going to try to sight in a gun now, because afterwards I will test it for ballistic precision. 298.7. 298.5. 300.2. This one was slightly lighter. 298.5. 297.8. Ooh, this was a flyer. Maybe it was me, because I did jerk the gun a little bit. I have to have 2 more shots. So 299.4, by the way, for the last one. And let's try one more. 2 more, sorry. 298.2. The accuracy is amazing. I'm really surprised myself. We did have one flyer, but other than that, it was just almost one point, one hole, everything. Okay, let's test for BC. The last velocity was 296.7, by the way. Okay, so we have one more test. We're going to calculate the BC from the readings of the crony downrange. So this is exactly 70 meters to the crony from the muzzle of my rifle. And we know that initial velocities of the bullets are in average 298 meters per second. And let's see what are they downrange. I sure hope I won't hit my crony. Let's try. error. 262.2. I think 265.6. We're gonna do an average. 265.6. Empty.
So that's quite big energy still retained at 70 meters.